Because it's really light.
Well, yeah, as long as you don't have to go uphill.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. We'll just come this way a little bit.
Yeah, right there.
That's where it's going to set.
That's it.
While I've got used to the tractor over here, I'm gonna go ahead and level all a spot for the shed, because we're gonna take the shed off the trailer and set it down on a little bit of a foundation to make it nice and solid. But I gotta level the spot out, so let's level it out. okay, I got foundation blocks to build a foundation under the shed, and the rest of the blocks I'm going to build
a little mountain thing for the goats to climb on and play on. Yeah, that's what I can do with my extra stones, because I took these out from the front yard because I'm getting ready to landscape the front yard. So let's get this place level. Okay, this is my highest point for the ground. I'm going to go 16 feet over. Okay, this is a 16 foot mark. Okay, I could not move it with my brawn. Just don't have enough brawn to move that one shed by myself. But I'm gonna use the old wisdom of our ancestors, like Archimedes and the Grecians and the Romans, and yes, even the ancient Egyptians. I'm gonna lift the shed all by myself, and we're gonna use bar and fulcrum. Well, look, I got a stable pillar base here. I got a long enough fulcrum, or this is my fulcrum point. I got a long enough bar here. Add some weight to the end and lift it. There we go. See?
But I do need a second pair of hands to put the bar under there. No I don't. I use my head. Watch. I just got a cement block as a counterweight. And I just move that up here. And it lifts this shed for me. So I don't have to. Need more weight. No problem. A little bit more lift. See? Use my brain instead of brawn. And I'm lifting it up high enough above the wheels so I can back the trailer out of here. So we just got to block the front part now. Okay. Now, to get the shed off of these beams and piers and lower it back down to the ground and get it back and get it into its position, we're just going to reverse the order. Thank you. Now I just have to move it that way a little bit. I gotta make sure my blocks are placed. Okay. Shed's now in place. So what do you think about them apples, huh? Oranges, grapes, whatever you want. I got the shed in place with the help of Jeremy moving the trailer. And then I had to move it out of the way myself. But then we got it moved back into place and I had to jack the shed up high enough to clear the wheels of the trailer and was able to back it out. So using a, you know, beam and fulcrum was the key for me to be able to use my brains instead of my brawn, just like what Archimedes may have done. And I know the Egyptians, the Grecians, the Romans, they all used the same thing. And Edward Leeds Scanlon even used them, the creator of the Coral Castle out there in Florida. Check him out. So, focus on your abilities, not your disabilities. That's what will help you succeed in life. Well, I'm Jerry Hansen, your host in another installment of getting the goat paddocks ready for the little bucks that I'll be getting in about 2 weeks maybe. Stay tuned to more videos. You could do that by subscribing and clicking that bell icon. That alerts you to new videos as I upload them. And hey, please click that share button and share my videos on your social media platforms. Really helps out the channel a lot. Like the channel with that thumbs up. That also helps us out. And also leave a comment if you will. Hey, we'll see you guys in the next episode. All right? Bye-bye.